Hey, welcome back everyone to another late night here on the East Coast. How y'all doing? Just noticed I gotta fix this a little bit here. Alright. Mostly okay. Seems alright. It's been a while since we've done Dwarf Fortress. It's one of my favorite games, gotta be said. I feel like a lot of people can probably say that. Not saying it's my favorite game, but it's one of them. It's certainly an amazing game. Everybody knows this. I mean, I've spoken about it before. The one downside of the game is it does take a while to create a world, and if we do create a world, I mean, it might not have the embark location we're really hoping for. But we can play with what we got, you know. All right, so we're gonna generate standard for all this kind of stuff here. We'll make the natural savagery high because I like that. Like everything to be a little bit, crazy. Get the combat from the get-go. That'll be fine. Holy shit, damn! All right, well that is sound sense. Gonna turn that down, maybe. There. Seems okay. Seems better. Whoa. Had a little heart attack when it loaded up. So we use a couple mods. I didn't use to mod this game ever, but I started using the Lazy Noob Pack. Essentially, I just used three little mods from it. You've Sound Sense. It gives. Well, Tarred Atoms does have an okay musical soundtrack. It is one that I will never be able to forget because it's ingrained in my head because it's just like a, I don't know, like a just a looping track, unfortunately. So Sound Sense does give you a little bit of music variety, which is nice. Also gives you a couple little sound effects, which are just they're fun. They just add a little bit to the whole experience. Use Rain. A lot of it is just sort of royalty-free stuff, just odd sound effects here and there. But it's nice. It adds a little bit of immersion. What else do I use? I use Dwarf Therapist, which I can bring up for you now. No, not that one. Here we go. As Dwarf Therapist, most people use this. It actually took me a long time to get around to using this guy. I still don't use it as much as I probably should. Yes, that's right, Broad. That means press hold shift and slash. Yeah. Everything in this game has a shift and a regular key. It's very intense. If you don't know Dwarf Fortress, or not that well, I can explain that super quick. Toady One, this guy made it. His name's Tarn Adams. He has made one of the most intense simulator games out there. It's very cool. There's a lot going on. Unfortunately, the game is extremely complicated. Takes a very long time to learn. It's not overly hard, but to learn all the little intricacies, it does take a very long time, yeah. So we're gonna generate this here to about near 200-ish, maybe 150 if I'm feeling impatient. And then we'll go ahead and try and settle somewhere. But yeah, so everything has a shift and a non-shift, and the question mark is literally shift, slash. A lot of crazy little stuff like that. A lot of hotkeys in this game. I don't even know them all. I know a good amount of them, and that helps, but hotkeys just speed things up, though, so it's not the end of the world. Anyway, yeah, Dwarf Therapist is pretty cool. It lets you micromanage your dwarves a lot better. I actually just use it. People go crazy with it, and they've been going crazy with it for years, but I just use it to keep track of who the new migrants are. So I can see who the new people are and then rename them from that screen. It makes it a lot easier for me. Because otherwise, when you get new people, they're automatically mixed in with your old people. What I used to do is, last time we played this, I guess it was closer to a year ago, eh? When we played this last. Yeah, but I had the follower list, and I would just take people from the follower list or that I saw in chat, and I would make them people in the game. First person you click on is now named Bob. Please no. Not like this. Now, some people, you know, most of the time, you'll have people use a follower list or whatever to name people in games, like Dwarf Fortress, and it doesn't really matter, but I like it, personally, because assigning a name that's not a default dwarf name, because I've seen them so many times, helps me associate a character with actions, and then it helps me remember the fun times, and the interesting moments, and the, oh, do you remember when? Because I can still regale you from the last time we played this, which again was like a year ago. You know, I could tell you what Zelfus did. I could tell you who Wargames was. Wargames was our incompetent mayor. Kept demanding silver everything. And banning export of it. We had Shagel, who went completely insane because he wanted a very specific piece of thread. And we struggled so hard to try and get him that one piece. When we first got to the fortress, we had to fight off alligators for like 2 months or something. Just 2 months straight. The first 2 months of the fortress was everybody stripped naked, wrestling alligators, trying to hold them off and secure the landing zone. I think that's actually when Origami... I think he was the captain of the guard then. Yeah, I was doing like a tutorial, Origami, yeah. I believe your character, sort of, for some reason, was doing something else and then rushed in. Oh, were you? No, you were the migrant wave. That's what happened. We got migrants. So imagine this, right? These guys have been wrestling these alligators. You know, they set out and they're like, okay, everybody, we're leaving. We're going to create a new fortress here. And then what happened is, you know, 2 months later, they're still fighting these alligators, naked, bloody, bruised. The alligators and the people, the dwarves, are now all unconscious and dehydrated and just laying on the ground. And then Origami comes in with the migrant wave, and they attempt to fight them off, and then they're wrestling them on the ground and stuff like that. And that lasted for like another month, and we almost lost a few people, actually. So let's go ahead and use the world as it currently exists. That'll be fine. Man, it was crazy. And we had Grazilian, who is our insane butcher. And I think we're going to bring him back. I really liked having Grazilian as our butcher. And I liked having... we had the morgue in behind his butcher shop, which was quite fun. And then his bedroom was off from that. That's fine. Box strap. Strasp. The absolute planets. Interesting region name. Now the real question. Bag in, bag out, or coffee? Let's see what kind of people you are. But that's what I mean. Like, I love putting names on it. Not just because it's good for you guys. I mean, certainly if I was to watch... sort of a more narrative experience. I would love to have a character named after myself. It just gets you more into it, in my opinion. It gets you more hyped up. It's a very cool thing. And what I used to do, again, back in the day, way before I used to stream, I'm always a bag in as well, borrowed. Way before I used to stream, I used to do AARs, which is an after-action report. And I would play a game and take constant screenshots because there wasn't really... a lot of video recording technology at the time, there was, and I did some recording as well, but you couldn't, like, record several hours of footage, and it didn't make sense to record a bunch of sort of 30-second clips. So, yeah, I I would take all these screenshots and then I would type up a story as to what happened. I wouldn't, you know, I might embellish a few things, but for the most part, I would tell as it was, and people found it very interesting. There's a Hypercam, absolutely. And yeah, I had a good amount of people that were interested in that. It was a lot of fun, and I would take people's names. One of my most popular ones was we did, I did so much Blood Bowl, and we'll get back to Blood Bowl at some point, but it's one of those things. I don't know if Blood Bowl will ever reach the charm and the fun and the excitement I had of back then getting these screenshots and, you know, sending them off with these stories. And now Blood Bowl, I'd stream before I did the Blood Bowl AARs, I should clarify, but I used to do other ones before that. And just having everybody, you know, so excited as to, you know, how the games are going and all that kind of stuff, wondering what happened to their players. Did they score a touchdown? It was a really good time. Let's go ahead and start playing in Boxstrasp. We'll do Age War Fortress. But one that I did before I streamed that was very popular in high school, I had a few people in high school, is... where are we embarking? So we arrive on the 15th of Granite. It's not too bad. We're in the nice spring. It was a really old DOS game. I think it was Buck Rogers Countdown to Doomsday. Pretty sure. An absolutely amazing little game. Maybe I should bring that back. There's a lot of these little games. I wish I was a bigger streamer. Again, not for me. I mean, I would love it. You know what I mean? But mostly because I would just love to introduce people to some of these like little weird games that are just absolutely amazing. But time is sort of forgotten. We're going to make our embark location probably 6-6. That's a little bit higher than normal, actually, but my computer's pretty good. Tor Fortress still, I think, only runs on a single core, but I have pretty high cores. So that'll be cool. Savagery and Evil, I don't really care. I prefer them to be high, but we'll see what we get because we really want no aquifers. I hate those. We do want that. We want multiple shallow metals, multiple deep metals. Rivers are very good. Fluxstone layer, that would be very cool. Everything else, sure. High elevation would be awesome. If we can't get it, that's okay. While we're at it, let's just search for high savagery as well. Evil, I'll take it or leave it. Evil's a very hard start, but I don't mind. But no, I won't embark with an aquifer. It's not impossible, but it is a huge pain in the ass. But yeah, Buck Rogers was a lot of fun doing that one. What I actually used to do before I did AARs even, and again, this is before streaming, is in very early high school, I think even at the end of grade 8 I might have done this. This is really nerdy, dumb shit that nobody probably cares about, but I used to write stories. I used to write a lot of sort of, never like a full book, but I used to write a lot of stories, more like a short story type of thing. But then what I started doing was I would write a story and I would have people, before I started writing a story, give me a lot of, sort of give me characters. I would just take some stuff down, much like role-playing is. But this was before I was able to do a proper role-playing group. So I would take all this character information and names and stuff like that, and then I would write a story. And then at certain points, I would just send the current story off to everybody, and then I would ask them, you know, what do you want to do type of thing, or what do you feel about this, or whatever. And the most success I ever had was I did one in the Resident Evil universe. And again, it's very much like a role-playing game, except it was the DM wrote most of the stuff. They just had a little bit of input here and there from the characters. It's similar to role-playing, but it's not, because obviously you're not doing it at the same time and you're not in the same room and all that kind of cool stuff. But it was a really weird, interesting experience, and you know, for the time did fairly well. Just it was a lot of fun. Wouldn't do it anymore. I prefer actual role playing. But it was an interesting thing I did. Certainly have a lot of time to talk while we wait for Dwarf Fortress here. Jeez, what else did I do? I used to draw comics all the time. Let's begin the drawing comics. So we're gonna go ahead and turn our savagery down to medium. Well, not low, that would be annoying. Well, we'll just say NA. Hopefully we can get the multiple shallow metal. But yeah, I used to draw a lot of comics, and eventually in high school, actually, I drew like just Stickman comics, sort of in grade 7, grade 8, but they were pretty funny. In grade 9 and on, I actually did proper comics, and I had several different characters and different strips, and the most popular one was Smokey. He was like a little black mage from Final Fantasy, essentially, like from Final Fantasy like 1 and 2. He was a really cool character though. He had like floating hands, shot a lot of guns. He was just a little asshole, as is sort of common for a high school type character. But yeah, he was really funny, and obviously there's a lot of video game sort of not references, but I suppose influence in it. He was good though. I actually sold off, like I had essentially I would put it all in a binder. Choose your own adventure origami, that's what you're thinking of. But yeah, I had them all in a binder, and I sold the binder off at the end of high school because unfortunately I'm, well, I suppose I was a bit more of a drama queen back then. But anyway, I sold it off for a pretty penny. No idea what happened to it, if it's still around. But it was kind of a cool thing. I actually had a web page as well that had like thousands of views, which back then was pretty big on GeoCities. And I would upload a series of comics onto that. Never really pursued that further though. Oh, hey, we found one. Excellent. But, you know, it was an interesting time. But yeah, I was very much an artist in high school, and in some ways, you know, I still feel like I'm a little bit, but very much an artist, and so much so that it got to the point where, unfortunately, I just started the same search again. Damn it! I think if I escape. We're still looking at the place we were just looking at, and everything will be cool and gravy. We are. Okay. So let's see what we have here. Warm temperature, no trees, thick vegetation, untamed wilds. Temperate mountain, thick, untamed wilds. Okay. Shrubland. All right, well, this is good. This is actually excellent. We're gonna find out if this is an okay embark in a second. Yeah, I'll finish what I was saying. But if something wasn't perfect, I would just scrap it completely. And things over time would stop being perfect. So I ended up throwing out, burning, etc., a lot of my art, because I just ended up not being happy with it, you know. Couple of months down the road. So neighbors, dwarves and humans. Shit. All right, we're gonna have to do another search, unfortunately. That's really frustrating. This is a newer edition of the game I completely forgot about. is, it's not new. It's like maybe 2 years old new. But it's new because it wasn't in the majority of Dwarf Fortress I played. But essentially, if you don't embark with a goblin or similar fortress, you know what I mean? Or like if you look at your neighbors essentially, and there's nobody that is, you know, an antagonist, you'll never get sieged. Which is frustrating, and I didn't realize it that because again, we when we played our previous fortresses, we did two, I think two fortresses and never had anybody siege us. because we just didn't have them as neighbors. It used to be they would always happen though. And I can appreciate it. Oh, please don't make me have to do an aquifer. Oh, I think I'm gonna have to. That's brutal. All right. But yeah, it was good times. Like I can see why they do it though. It's so it's you know, if you want to play a more peaceful, relaxing fortress and not get invaded, you can turn that off, but I assume it's because a lot of this here is jungle sort of territory in this world, which is interesting. So there's gonna be aquifer stuff. We found one somewhere. And where are you on the map? Yeah, the same place we already looked at. Yeah, it doesn't look like we're gonna have much luck here, boys. All right. Oh, there's another one. There's another one. It's gonna have lower elevation, but that's okay. You can definitely work around that. As long as we have goblins, I mean, I would love to have everybody. Okay, let us browse results. What do we got? No, dwarves, elves, humans, and tower. Unfortunately, no enemies. Yeah, I it's one of those things. An aquifer is not impossible to deal with, right? It's just nasty. You can. Well, hang on, let's check this first result right here. No, only dwarves, so that one doesn't work. We might have to generate a whole new world. Actually. Let's find out. Okay, there are goblins on the map. It's possible to have a spawn where goblins are just not there. Like, you know what I mean? Like, they're not something you can have. Like, you can spawn a world without them, which is kind of a huge pain in the ass. We could make our embark larger and have a better chance. But we're going to go ahead and do this. We're probably going to be stuck with an aquifer. I'll probably cry a little bit, but we'll deal. If we're really unlucky, we'll be stuck with an aquifer and no hills. And then I'm really going to cry because then we're going to have the water right at the surface. It's not impossible. Again, you can essentially build pumps and pump out the aquifer, but it's a very complicated and pain in the ass procedure. So I'm hoping we can avoid that. And unfortunately, most boring part of the game is world and fortress embarkation spot pickery, but yeah, nothing you can really do about that. Do you know what I mean? If you get a bad embark, it's like, well. And there, it's one of those things. There will be people that say there's no such thing as a bad embark. There is. In my opinion, if you don't have different neighboring place like people, it's a bad embark, you know? I personally just love having the antagonist to worry about. You know, are the goblins gonna come attack me? Are they gonna sneak in and steal our shit? You know, have to have defenses ready. You know, that kind of stuff. You can always piss off somebody else, like the dwarves or the elves or the humans, but again, you don't always have them as neighbors either, so. Yeah, like it's doable origami. It is just a pain in the ass, though. All right. So we got a lot of spots with aquifers. That's good. I'm just gonna finish the search because I want to make sure we get one with goblins. I believe the lower regions of the map have goblins in them. This sort of area here, I think we saw some, but. Not 100%. And again, I'm sorry if this is boring, but still not a lot I can do in that regard. Okay, so not that one. Is there a way to switch between results or I forget. Probably not. Let's go the hard way. So, nope, just dwarves here. Dwarves, 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 dwarves. What about this guy here? Dwarves. Dwarves and humans. Just dwarves. Okay, dwarves and humans. Dwarves and humans. Dwarves, humans, and elves. Oh, okay. We're almost there. Man, that skin I ripped off my lip is really starting to bother me. Dwarves, humans, yeah. I think down here we should find some, no? I don't know what tower means. It sounds interesting. I kind of want to see what the tower are, but again, really looking for goblins, so. Yeah, dwarves, goblins, and humans right here. All right. Okay, so this hole seems like just this continent has them. What do we got? All right. Interesting. So it is a very hot woodland, moderate vegetation, wilderness. So it's not too dangerous for that kind of stuff. What's our elevation? Pretty low. But it does seem like there's a little bit of a mountain. Yeah, that'll do, actually. This is quite nice. Very well. It's a very large area, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I know. It's not actually that large. We will prepare for the journey carefully, and hopefully, I don't balls it up, which I've done before. Go ahead and name our fort, first of all. Dykewads. Emosh Dogik. We are Dykewads. I think Dykewads is a really, really, really funny name for a fortress. Wow. Normally, I just random so we get something good, but I don't think you can argue with Dykewads. All right. Dykewads it be. It's our group. The Unswerving Dagger, not bad. Sculpted Roads, Tired Tours, the Palm Standards of Life. I like that. I like that. That's very, very fitting and interesting. All right, let's go ahead and customize some of our characters real quick. We will have, well, Mr. Origami should, of course, have first crack at a character name. I'll put Borrowed second because he's hanging around right now. But absolutely, Origami was there for the first one. So, get Zelphus in here. Whew, that was close. Get Rudianwa. Herpigerst, which is actually a dwarf name. Well, Gerst, yeah. But anyway, right off the bat, it's off to a good start. I agree, Origami. I'm feeling pretty confident. Who else? Gotta have Grizzlian, but we can add him later. War Games, I would feel bad if War Games wasn't part of the first party. And George, you know? Good old George. I think we got everybody accounted for. We'll get Frost Cookies and all those people later. So Origami and Bored, if you've some sort of idea about what kind of dwarf you want to be. I'm sure Origami wants to be in the army again. And I'm sure Bored wants to be the asshole politician, so I can go ahead and do that. Otherwise, I'll just pick what we kind of need. Oh yeah, yep, that's. Yeah, I remember him. So for sure we need proficient miner. You can actually skimp on their mining. It helps a lot though. It really does. I think we'll have Zelphus and Rudy as our miners. Herpy is Asian. So I think he's got to be our doctor. I'm just kidding. It's tempting to bring a doctor at the get-go, though, because you're not guaranteed to get one later. But you're not going to need one for a long time. But did we promise Edge that he'd get a guy? I think we promised him for something else, like XCOM. But yeah, Edge is a great guy too. I mean, there's so many good guys. Like Glassblower? Oh God, we're not gonna do Glassblower. Like, well, I mean, I could, but like, we won't have a glass production up at start. I'm not even sure we have sand actually, which would be a bit odd. Okay. Well, let's see here. Put War Games in the farming. Because last time he was just an absolutely terrible, terrible. Mayor. Just awful. So he will be brewer and grower. Good morning, Mr. Durin. Currently 4:30 here on the East Coast. How about you? What else could we get going? No sand in the glass blower goes insane from lack of work. Yeah, that kind of stuff happens. Yeah, just in time for a new embark. We probably won't get too much in. I think we'll probably do about half an hour, and then I'll start heading to bed, unfortunately. Sorry, man. But you never know. Sometimes I don't notice what time it is. What are some things I really like to have in an embark? I like a mason, for sure. That helps a lot. Actually, I really like a carpenter, too. We'll have George be our carpenter. Origami wants to be in the army, so we'll go ahead and make him our woodcutter. And we'll give him the axe dwarf. So if need be, he can chop away at some people. And yeah, get bored going for being Mr. Social Butterfly. See, negotiator, persuader, judge, intent, appraiser, organizer, record keeper. Yep. I'm not sure Borod should have flattery. Maybe intimidation. I'm not sure about flattery though. Then we just got herpy. Keyboardist. Wow, that's cool. They added a lot of new stuff at some point. Geography? What? My goodness. That's actually one thing. Well, we don't need to put him a point to do that. Yeah, you're too blunt for flattery. I totally agree, Boron. What do we do with Herpy? We already got two miners. A mason would be really good, though. Perhaps we just go for masonry. We'll see what happens. I got some extra points. I think we actually Do you put those into medicine stuff? There. So yeah, he can be our sort of backup doctor, because we are going to need one. Two copper picks, absolutely. Just one copper battle axe, thank you. The iron anvil. Now, this is always tough. Iron anvils used to be worth a lot more. 100 points is still a lot of stuff. But, oh yeah, you're right. Herbert should definitely have his oboe skill. We'll take 1 point off his masonry. That'll be alright. He'll still be a pretty good mason. And wind instrument. Perfect. So it's always tempting not to take the iron anvil because we don't need it till later. And we can always try and buy one. So I think we're going to do that. We're going to need a lot more plump helmet spawns than that. Like a lot. Pigtail seeds, yep. And the other stuff we don't really need as much. We'll just keep a little bit of them, but we don't really need them. Cavefish, yeah, that's all cool. Thread cloth, bags, and ropes. Okay, we don't need the rope. It's useful, we don't need it. Take one bag. We don't really need the cloth. The thread we need, just in case. Quiver? No, we don't really need any quivers. We're not going to do any of that stuff. Buckets, splints, crutches. Again, we can produce this stuff ourselves. I'm going to start with splints and crutches just in case, though. The wheelbarrow and the stepladder we don't need. And the buckets I can make, but splints and crutches are just a nice just in case. Oh, how do you know if your sieve has no iron, Durin? Also, I think we have humans we can trade with. So, as well. But, oh, that would be a bit annoying. So there's a little bit of a trick to this game. Unless they've changed it, you get a free barrel for every different type of food you order. So we're just going to buy a whole bunch of different types of foods and just get a ton of different like free barrels, essentially, because you go through a billion barrels in this game. I mean, you can reuse them, but you still end up having so many. And we're going to want to look into having some pets in there as well. Oh, okay. Thanks, Durin. That makes sense, yeah. Okay, again, we want all the different types of beers, alcoholic stuff. Yeah, leather's cool, we don't need that. We don't need any of this stuff here. Now, here's another interesting thing. We're going to take sand just in case we don't have it and somebody goes insane and needs it. It's happened to me before. Because it's something I always forget to order. But again, a bag is like 10, I think. It's quite a bit. Hang on, let's see. Crafts, bag. Nope. Ah, there we go. So, like, a bag is 10, right? But sand is 1, but it comes in a bag, so it's like, what? But, you know, stuff. Okay, we don't need any of you. I think I'm going to take a cave spider silk rope, just because ropes are pretty useful in the beginning. Let's get our animals first. I'm tempted to take ducks, sure, we'll take geese, sorry. I believe it's geese. They plant eggs. You can get that set up at some point. Sometimes I forget to do it, but they're pretty good, and they're cheap, end of the day, so, you know. You can always butcher them, too, I guess. Dogs would be really good. It's always good to have dogs. There they are. So we'll grab two boy dogs and two girl dogs. I'm too cheap to make them hunting or war dogs. And yeah, we'll just go ahead and grab our meats of different kinds. I'll use the rest of our points. I almost think it's better to spend these points on leveling somebody up. Almost. I'm not sure what I would get them, though. Now, here's the annoying thing. There's like a huge stack of stuff that's worth 8, and I don't really want it. So, yeah. Oh, well. What can you do? Yeah, so Sound Sense was joining us. I apologize. Durin, I'm going to apologize since you're new to the chat. Sometimes when I say S's, I have trouble saying them, and I try and work my way around them so I don't make a whistle, but it's hard for me. I apologize. It's something, unfortunately, I've got to deal with. So you guys are only miners. George was our witch now. Carpenter. No, you're just going to be on carpentry, so not really worth putting any stuff into that. Also, as the night goes on, I do tend to A, ramble more, and I already ramble a lot, and B, slur my words, stutter on occasion, but mostly just slur. I try not to, but eh. Bring some more plump helmets, probably. Just the spawn, I think, will be fine. Maybe we just bring more booze. Yeah, I think we just bring more booze. I'm gonna need a good amount of that. So it'll be a while before I set up alcohol production, most likely. Actually, there's something to be said. If we go to Zelfus and Rudy, giving them a couple points in just, for example, swordsman even, and if we give them armor user, wrestler, that would be good. I don't think I have enough points to get that on Rudy. Okay, we're actually going to take off some of our alcohol here. Armor user and swordsman. Nice. I think I can buy them another thing each here. Just give them fighter, I guess. Shields are pretty good too, actually. Probably good to be proficient in shield. Let's do that. So this way, if I do need to, you know, immediately start fighting or something happens, I have three people with weapon skills, so they're not gonna, like, crazy, like, rage at me. When I say, hey, whoa, guys, we got problems. Grab a sword and fight the horde. And all that kind of stuff. I'll actually give George our carpenter something as well. Just nice to have some draftability going on. I mean, I like hammers a lot, to be honest, but... eh. I always find my way into obsidian, so... end up using those good old swords. Yeah, well... yeah, that's fine. It's not the end of the world. We'll live. So, we're all good. We'll save this as... Twitch 2016. And just a quick reminder, boys... hit the embark button. Hope I didn't miss anything. I've done it before. Oh, yes, I have. Oh, yeah. I missed some pretty obvious shit before. Completely unintentional, but I've done it. Now we hold on to our nuts and we hope that the not responding is a loading not responding and not a oh, we're not responding anymore. You never know with Dwarf Fortress. You never know. Every time the auto save feature kicks in, I have a minor heart attack. I'm like, either.
Welcome to our new home.
There we go.
Make the best of it. Let's start digging.
Let's start digging. Ha ha. Thanks, Sound Sense. Anyway, you have arrived after a journey from the mountain homes into the forbidding wilderness beyond. Your horse trek has finally ended. Your party of seven is to make an outpost for the glory of all of Nishmatul. There are almost no supplies left, but with stout labor comes sustenance. Whether by bolt, plow, or hook, provide for your dwarves. You're expecting a supply caravan just before winter entombs you. But it is spring now, enough time to delve secure lodgings. Ere the jaguars get hungry, a new chapter of dwarven history begins here at this place. Imush Dugik, Dykewads, strike the earth. I love jaguars. Durin, we were talking about this earlier. One of our previous embarks, I think it was about a year ago actually we did it, was literally the first 2 to 3 months were just wrestling alligators because they spawned on top of us. That was lots of fun. And actually we have a very similar start as that time. Lots of jungle. And I like that. We turned up the savagery of the world because I find that fun, gotta be said. But that's just me. Okay, so first thing, we're gonna go ahead and chop down. Well, we're gonna turn that off, that drives me nuts. I'm gonna go ahead and chop down some trees here. Just in this sort of, you know, general immediate area. And before I forget, so Borod is our expedition leader. Let's go ahead and view him as a unit here. Labor, gonna give him. So it's not engineering, it's architecture. Perfect. So Borod will walk over and manage and design, you know, sort of check off like, yep, okay, that's a bridge. And then they'll build it. So right from the get-go, we're going to want to set up, we're going to want to dig into here. What is this anyway? We are sandy loam wall. Okay, so there is a little bit of sand and stuff like that. Let me know if the audio is too loud. Hey, FlexPoint89, how you doing, man? This looks a little nicer here. Just clay, though. Yeah. Still, not bad. Pretty sure the mountain was supposed to be on this side, but I guess that never ended up being a thing. Just trees. Yeah, gotta love new embarks, eh? So sand. Alright. I'm not a big fan of sand. Also not a big fan of aquifers, and unfortunately we have one here somewhere. It might be here that we dig in the corner. I like to be more central, though. So we'll probably use this area here. Trying to keep your own fort alive? That's the life, man. So we need a 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright, that's where our trade caravan's gonna go. We're gonna wanna chop down these trees so they don't get in the way of that. We'll worry about everything else after. We're going to want to BCW. Okay, so we got to chop the trees first. That'll be fine. We'll start our digging. See what happens. In the beginning, there's going to be a lot of people not really doing anything. But, you know, that's fine. You know, one of my favorite things about Dwarf Fortress is the community. Gotta be said. I love the kind of people you meet. When you talk about Dwarf Fortress, when you play Dwarf Fortress, all that kind of stuff. So, we might do something as simple as this for now. I think actually... Yeah. We're going to make this an sort of impromptu barracks. We're going to build all our beds here. And so for right now, let's build our carpenter's workshop. Right here, I think, would probably be fine. Actually, let's place it a little further out again. We don't want to accidentally block the caravan. Sorry, tired. So we're going to remove up downstairs ramps. It's going to be a huge job that our miners get up to. I'm going to get rid of all this. Okay, so we should be able to build our walls now. And we're going to build them in right here. Try to do it here, I think. That's where I want that. Actually, we could just use this as a natural wall to the west. Probably just do it that way. So if we do it from, say, here's pretty safe. Perfect. Yeah, I gotta love that Dwarf Fortress. You can literally go years without playing it and you're still... You still think about it. And that's actually one of the things we've been having right now is I love strategy games. I play a lot of strategy games, and then all of a sudden I went like a long period without playing them, and just the last week I was like, you know what, wow, I need my strategies, I need my sims, I need everything. Sorry, can we shrink that? Perfect. So, but it's okay, we're back there. So we're going to have our borrowed, I think, has to go ahead and do this. No, he doesn't. All right, awesome. So is anyone with wall floor construction, can just go ahead and bring all the wood that we're chopping down and chop-a-chop, build this up. Oh, really, Flexpoint? No, I think Dwarf Fortress is a bit easy, personally. I'm normally, like, once you reach a certain point, which it's not, in my opinion, hard to get to, it's sort of impossible to lose, which is why I get a little bit upset and frustrated if I'm not playing on a map with all of, like, goblins and everything like stuff. And one thing I love about streaming, actually, is I don't actually have to have the wiki open. Because I have all you wonderful people. And for the most part, yeah, you guys are great about telling me when I've made a little mistake. I don't mean that in a bad way. I mean, like, you guys are awesome. Like, you can be like, oh, did you know it's actually like this? I'm like, ah, yes, whoops. You know what I mean? So we set our pen pasture here, so hopefully they'll go ahead and eat. That's right, you have the wiki open for me. Borrowed Bullets, he's not talking too much in chat right now, but he's my go-to wiki man all the time. He's amazing. We'll just be playing any game and he'll be like, I'm Googling that. I don't know if that's correct, or, you know, I feel like... exhausted. But he'll help me a lot with if we're playing a game and there's some sort of really questionable thing going on. We're not sure if it's a bug or whatever. He's always Googling it for me. He's a great guy. And we got a pretty chill here chat. So, oh, you're gonna rage quit? That's fair enough, man. Probably heading off to bed in the next, like, 20 minutes, but we'll see. Ah, this music's so good. Alright. Go ahead and make me a bunch of beds there. So, can I build a farm plot on this? Yes, I can. Well, that does make things easier. Alright. Does make things easier. Let's go ahead and designate our farming area then. It's climbing of invaders. What do you mean? Sorry. Like them coming over walls or? As I always just remove all the stairs and stuff. And no, I'm playing the most recent Dwarf Fortress Origami. I finally upgraded. I did. I don't normally, but over walls or down from behind. Hey, my fairy, how you doing? Well, you can actually farm on stone. You just gotta be tricky about it. we had to do that in a previous run on this channel. The trick to, you sort of have to flood it to 3 out of 7 liquid, and then drain it. And you'll be able to, it's also the same way you get tower caps, actually. So we need to remove this wagon so they'll stop standing around there. Now, one thing I'd like to do is I personally, and you'll see I put up early walls, I'm just paranoid. I feel like that's not a bad thing. I also like to build early walls around my caravan. Most people are like, why are you building walls around your caravan? You know, you're just gonna have to get stuff from it. Yes, I know. But I have had too many monkeys happen to not. So we're gonna get that going. And once you have beds, you know, you got your other stuff. So, essentially, people, like, climbing is an issue. It's not as much an issue, but it depends who you get. You know what I mean? Just make sure I can still...
It won't work.
Construct building, creature occupying site. Oh, those freaking geese, though. But what you can do is... The walls are going to stop the majority of people. The very few guys are able to climb. And I found... Well, how I normally do a wall... Yeah, I know. You hate saying no to me, but no. What I normally do is... I'll just pause and show you real quick. So I've got my first wall here. And then I will actually have up here... It'll be a 2-thick wall. And then this will be a fortification... or you can just have another wall. But if you have a 2-thick wall, and this tier goes up one more tier, so it'll be 2 Z levels up, you generally pretty safe. For some reason, that kind of bugs them out. Alternatively, you can always just roof it. I don't think there's any problem with roofing anything. Yeah, monkeys make me pretty angry. Few things do, but monkeys? Yep, that's right, yep. What do you mean it won't work? Just kill the geese. It's fine. Okay. Have we removed this yet? No, we need the carpenter. Alright. Build our door then. Yeah, raiding monkeys were lots of fun, Origami. Okay, our carpenter's almost done. Carpenter's George, right? Yep. Excellent. We got Rudy and Zelphus chopping away at sand. Nice thing about sand is, is this sand or clay right here? It's sand. Nice thing about sand is the way it calculates leveling up mining is it goes based on the amount of tiles mined instead of the make a meeting zone. I have a pen pasture, but yeah, I can go ahead and do that as well. But the problem is you have to remove the you have to remove the wagon first. Because the wagon automatically counts as a meeting zone. They won't Like, they won't figure that out. Oh, okay. They are splitting. But if we had got rid of it, it would have been alright. Anyway, completely forgot what I was saying. I really apologize, everybody. Something about a something, and things happened. It's pretty fun. Oh yeah, so they level up based on the amount of tiles mined. So if you have them chew through this stuff, they go through it really fast and they level up really fast, which is pretty cool. So if you ever want to embark without high-level miners, just spend the first while just mining straight in the sand. Dingoes. I'm not sure if dingoes are hostile or not. They are known to attack livestock. Oh, fair enough. Should be good then. As dwarves don't normally count as livestock. Sometimes, but not always. Well, I wouldn't say that. I mean, RimWorld's just prison architect, but, you know. But the thing is, there's a lot of games that have claimed to be Dwarf Fortress with better graphics. Unfortunately, none of them are anywhere near the depth. And the depth is a lot of what brings me back to Dwarf Fortress, you know what I mean? It's not just building. I've played Space Base 13, for example. I've played a lot of these, you know, even going back. Dungeon Keeper was very much a very similar thing. You know what I mean? the thing is, and allow me to quote one of my biggest just mind-blowing moments, Bard, was a long time ago, they added a patch. It was a huge patch, because they'll normally only patch Dwarf Fortress like twice a year or something. Anyway, this patch comes out, and they added toenails to the game. You know, and you're like, oh, that's interesting. But the thing is, they added toenails to the game, but they never put any point for it to... They never added an AI for them to be cut. So these toenails would literally just grow forever and break and cause horrible infections and just awful things. Like, everything is so detailed, and I can go ahead and actually, if I... Oh, we'll bring up yourself, for example. If we go to Borrowed Bullets, let us read his thoughts. All randomly generated and all, like, change the way you think and go about doing stuff. It's really cool and interacting with things. There's nothing like a good friend. That's your quote. Within the last season, she felt fondness talking with a friend. She felt euphoric due to inebriation. Sounds like Borrowed. She was annoyed after having a drink without using a goblet, cup, or mug. Oh, that's a new thing. She was annoyed when caught in the rain. She's an ardent worshipper of Thyken. She's a citizen of the trade of dancing. She's a member of the Palm Standards of Life. That's our group that we settled with. She's the expedition leader of the Palm Standards of Life. She arrived at Imush Dogik, aka Dykewads, on the 15th of Granite in the year 159. If we go down, it's like, you know, 62 years old, born on this day. Her narrow amethyst eyes are bulging. Her somewhat narrow ears are splayed out. Her nose is hooked. Her hair is clean shaven. Her hair is taupe. Her skin is brown. She's tough, but she's slow to heal. You like conglomerate, iron, topaz, giant bobcat leather, moose antler, the color mahogany, anvils, cows for their haunting moos, the words of the wreath of grass, and the way the sound of sweet silk. When possible, she prefers to consume giraffe and turnip wine. You absolutely detest toads. She has a way with words, but has a poor memory. Like others in her culture, she holds craft worship of the highest ideals. Like, I could read this all day. I love it. I love it. But it's crazy, yeah. You know, just it's so deep. So deep. And you know, one thing I think I'm going to do is... maybe at the end of every session for the night, I'll go ahead and I'll just look at all the new people from that like session... Or maybe I'll just do it when we get a new person. That actually makes more sense. So let's go ahead and we're going to look at everybody briefly. We're not going to read them, but I'll just like put them up for like 5 seconds. And that way, you know, if you're curious about how your character is or what their backstory is, you can read them. Because I find this stuff fascinating. I'm huge into backstory in games. But anyway, Let's go ahead and we'll just do it super quick because I'll forget. I'm terrible. I know. How can someone be so consumed by hate? That's literally Zelfus talking about Borrowed right now. Jeez, calm down, nerds. We shall be so lucky as to truly master a skill. Nice, Rudy. Nice. Apparently Rudy's last name is Spearwaxes. I don't really know what that means, but... And George? What's this about proper living? Right on. Right on. And don't worry, we'll get migrants and we'll have the rest of you guys. Flex point, Durin, eat my ferret, of course. Of course, at some point. I talk to my friend, I feel fond. That's very origami. Hull Gulf. Okay. And of course, Herpy. You must never forget true loyalty. Repay it in full. Very Asian. That's about right. Got war games here. I'm curious. Tell me everything. What a guy. I believe that was everyone. Yeah, we just did Borrowed. So, I mean, we've got our stuff done. We don't really need to designate stockpiles for all the stuff in here because, again, we've walled it off. Except for the fact there's stuff blocking the door. That's awkward. We could dump it. You know what? Actually, now might be a good time to set up the dump. Yeah. I think that's probably a safe thing to do. So this will be our garbage dump. And we're gonna designate... Was it here to... dump everything? Nope. There was some way to mass dump. Set order. Nope, not that one. Designate now. Oh, cool, I can set hauling routes. That's not what I want, though. I thought it was in designate somewhere. There's just a weird thing for it. Was it Shift D? I thought Shift D was actually how you see the trader, whether they can make it or not. But I guess we don't have a trading depot, so I can go ahead and build that. Let's actually build our beds. Oops, sorry. Don't want to build a coffin, not yet. Excellent. Okay. Let's queue up some things. We're gonna need... we're gonna need some shields and swords. Just in case. And they won't do a lot, but it's just nice to have it. And then probably just get to work on... What? Chairs would be good. Honestly, we're going to be needing barrels. That's going to be our big thing. So let's go ahead and build our farm plots. Get that up and running. The faster you get agriculture going, the better it'll be for you in the long run. I think actually we shorten it this way one. Or do we keep it... Yeah, that's what we'll do. Shorten it that way, one. And we will set a food stockpile right here. And we'll set our actual garbage somewhere in here. We might not worry about that for now. Let's get our mason workshop set up. Okay, we can't really do anything with that just yet. But we could also set up a wood stockpile. That might not be a bad idea. We don't need wheelbarrows though, so there's that. And we have enough wood like right now. I just mean like at some point we're gonna want to reclaim all this and keep it inside so it's a little safer. But that's okay. I forget how you mass dump things though. It's driving me nuts. I thought it was an I. No, it's not there. let's see. There's a weird button for it. No, not that one. Let's look through all this stuff here. No. Ah, good. Okay, well, depot access is now a thing. We don't have our depot done. But now at least we can check. Okay. Alright, well, we need to figure out how far down stone's gonna be. The hippies are coming, yeah. Now, this may not be our main fortress. We might be relocating it. But for right now, we're just gonna have a little basic staircase going down. Because I want to know. Well, actually, we just want a downstair here, to be honest. Because I want to know how far down the aquifer is. I want to know how far down stone is. Okay, we also need some doors. You guys ever had red tea? It's really good, actually. Check the embark for iron beforehand, or is it blind? What do you mean blind, Durin? Sorry. Our, the civilization we're allied to, these guys here, they have iron and steel anvils, so we can acquire that at a later date. There's flux stone, so we know we're guaranteed to be able to make iron, but we don't know where it is, so. So who's not doing anything? Okay, everybody's doing something, I'm happy. And we forgot to make this a bedroom here. Well, start on the far bed. There we go, sort of. Yeah. That's good enough. This is, of course, our dormitory. Really? Lots of gold, silver, sometimes not even copper. Wow, that's rough, dude. Dwarffortress.exe has stopped working. I've had that happen a few times, Flexpoint. The many time in my time playing game, I have it happen, you know? It's not good, man. I don't recommend it. Not much you can do about it, but it happens. I always recommend set your auto saves once a month. Well, not a month, but once a season. Otherwise, you're going to have a bad day. Oh, this is Dwarf Therapist, by the way. I told you guys I was going to try and use it more, but here she be. So that's what that looks like, Borod. We don't need to use it right now. I only use it for migrants and stuff like that, just so I can organize it when I have like 100 dwarves. For right now, I just do it all manually in the game, because I find that works just perfectly. You have a set of season as well. That's good. All right, so we have this. We're going to set our still up, so we can go ahead and brew some beer. And at this point, we go, hey, War Games. You're a pretty cool guy. You're a farmer. How's it feel? That's excellent. What do you know about hauling? Nothing. Nothing anymore. You don't haul. It's not something you do. Alright. Because we need him to make the beer, and we need him to plant the seed. And that's it. Yeah, I'm drinking red tea right now. It's really good, actually. I personally find the beginning of a fort the most fun. I'm always like that in any game. Like Minecraft, Terraria, any sort of that kind of a game. Like, the most fun to me is the beginning, and then after that, I'm like, eh. Alright, well, we already found Dampstone. That wasn't far. So, that's good. Our aquifer is, what, 3Z levels down? We got 1, 2, 3. 3 levels down. That's, oh, no, shit. Oh, it's right on the stone level. Of course it, oh, this is clay. It's not even stone. Ugh. Ugh. What kind of dwarf doesn't have access to stone? This is going to be interesting. I'm not used to not having a stone. Can we build everything out of wood? Yes, we can. Do I want to? Well, no, but that's all right. Well, if we're going to have to be working with lots of wood, which it seems like we're going to. Assemble complete musical instruments and construct single piece instruments. Like what? Stationary percussion instrument. Rukul drum. Cool. But no, I just need lots of wheelbarrows. Lots of those. Stepladders would be cool too. But we're going to need that for our wood stockpile, which we're going to have to set up. Well, we can always go for fun below. Yeah. Oh yeah. We could definitely drown. Wait until winter to dig. Yeah. That's the plan, Origami. We're going to wait till winter. We're going to dig our entire fortress underground, and then we're going to flood it when the spring comes. Sounds like a great idea. We'll get there eventually. I'm not sure what my plan is, but we'll get there. Yeah, bro. You can do stuff with clay. I don't, because I'm a dwarf. Dwarves use stone. And apparently wood. Apparently, anyway. Let's go ahead and chop these trees down. They're upsetting me. They're actually not bothering me that much, but I want to be able to... Interesting that you can, say, cut down the top part of that tree and not the bottom, but anyway. We want this area cleared of trees so they don't overgrow our walls. Seems dangerous watching it, like, actually collapse everywhere, but hey, what can you do? Clay is for the weak non-bearded creatures, like goblins. Yeah, that's right. Still never beat that built that trade depot. Just George is too busy doing all the good stuff. What a winner. Gotta love George. Alright, let's go ahead and put a giant wood stockpile here. Probably 5 wheelbarrows is okay. Not sure how many I built, but let's build some more anyway. So my favorite use of, I mean, Boro mentioned Woodstock, because we were talking about wood stockpiles. Favorite use of Woodstock is in the movie. It's one of my favorite bad movies, if you will. It's just such a weird niche, and like, I don't, for some reason, no other movie has done what it has done, I guess. It's just a really weird combination of things. But it's my science project, and the professor talks about Woodstock quite a bit in that movie. But just the ending bit where he's going on about Woodstock's really funny. I find. Did somebody bleed right here? No, it's Loam. Oh, do tell, Flexpoint. I don't read TV tropes at all, so I don't know anything about it. That's right, Jiren. If you have a beard, you have a responsibility to act like a man. Swim in lava, cook everything with fire, and, you know, chop down all the trees. Build everything out of stone. Absolutely the way you should live your life. I do some of those things, you know. I cook and I burn myself every day, so I'm at least getting the fire down. What did you just put here, you little shit? Oh, it's a wheelbarrow. Let's make this up to 10. We're going to be hauling a lot of wheelbarrows. Never trust an elf. Too tall, too skinny, no beards, live above ground. They're unnatural. Well, Borrowed, funny you mention that. We might be building an above-ground fortress. At least for now, because we don't have a great way. We don't have enough people. Now, here's sort of the interesting problem. If you don't dig down, you don't get access to minerals. Minerals, and mining, gems and stuff like that, is the easiest way to increase your net worth. Because we can't do that, we don't have a great way of increasing the value of our fortress. Ergo, we're just in this, like, really weird place where we're not really going to get migrants. So we might be building above ground. That might actually be happening. What is the current value? Well, we don't have a broker. We're not going to have a broker for a while, actually. That's fine. So I need our trade depot set up. Then we gotta figure out what's going on. Now, if I hit civilizations, is that because I haven't found anyone else? Because I really don't want to have to restart this already. But I feel like it should say the goblins here, right? Because when I embarked, I made sure there was frickin' goblins in the embark. Like, I'd be really sad. I spent like an hour trying to find like an embark of the goblin or something. But if that's the case, I mean, yeah, we'll start this over. Create a whole new world, because apparently the last one flew away on a magic carpet of bullshit. And as per usual, Borrowed's the only one not doing anything, which is fine. Okay, perfect. So, yeah, we do have depot access. Very good. Very good. Okay, we're actually going to lower the stockpile here. Chop it down about... that. We want wood here, but we don't need to worry too much about it. So what do we do with no stone? I don't know if building walls counts for our, like, value. Maybe. Let's go ahead and chop these down then. Thanks, Bard. I mean, we might have to, because I don't see goblins in the civilization list, and I'm not sure if that's because we haven't met them yet. Like, do you know what I mean? Because I think the humans should be there at least anyway. But, oh well. We'll find out. You don't normally find out until year two anyway. So this is whetstone. stamp. Well, actually, that stamp too, yeah. All right. All right. Well, I guess we just start doing this. I did check the neighbors in the embark screen, yep. But that's what I'm saying, like, I don't see it here, so I'm wondering if it just didn't work again. I've had a lot of bad luck with not getting anyone to show up in previous playthroughs, so... there's a way of check. Oh, I balls this up. How do I do that? Ugh, that's slightly annoying. Not like end of the world annoying, but... There we go. And I don't know, I love just relaxing these games. So that's how many there? It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I wonder if I got enough room to... Let's finish building those first. That's right, yeah. Outside home still pumps. Yep. At least you're getting bigger homes than I would give you normally. If you were inside, you wouldn't get anywhere near as big. So, hauling wood is kind of a pain and slows everybody down, so I'm actually just going to make that stockpile extremely small. And, yeah. Music reminds you a lot of RuneScape. Yeah, it's quite nice. I mean, the actual game doesn't have music, really. It does, but it's not amazing. But Soundscape adds a lot of music, and it is a very awesome mod. Just kind of makes it nice to relax and chill and have a good time. Where's that tree? Oh, we still need to cut it down. That'd be super cool if you could do that, Mr. Woodcutter Man. Hey, what are you up to? Cutting wood? No, it looks like you're in the middle of building wall. I mean, I can't fault you for building walls, really, can I? Building walls are pretty useful. Well, it's summer already. Apparently we're not building a wall there anymore. I don't know why. Yeah, we're gonna need a lot more doors as well. So no migrants. Well, yet, anyway. We might get one. But I doubt we're going to get any migrants. Because we don't have any... Well, we got a thief coming in. Spotted one, anyway. Oh, that's alright, Origami. Thanks, though. So, we met... Okay, there's a kobold civilization. Or at least we've met one. Alright, so maybe we just have to meet them. It's not a YouTube playlist, but yeah, it's a bunch of songs taken from stuff. Herpy, why can't you build? It's always Herpy. It doesn't want to build. Because, oh, there's a thief here, or this, that, there. You know. Oh, goodness, guys, please. Just keep building the stuff. Don't worry about the thief. It'll be fine. I mean, he can steal something, actually, because they can go through doors. And, in fact, this door isn't even shut because there's beer in the way, but yeah. Let's get some of these doors going anyway. I'm hoping that some of this ends up increasing our worth. I know it won't much, because it's wood. I mean, as long as we keep him on carpentry, it's possible. Okay, who's not doing anything right now? Really? Herpy's not going to do anything for a very long time, because he's a mason. So... let's put him on woodcrafting. That sounds good to me. And we'll just have him build a ton of beautiful little wooden trinkets. There we are. So, build, workshop, or craft dwarf. Get one of those going. Yeah, they're pretty good songs, yeah. Now, we could have made this easier for our dwarves, but... can't just plant... So we're out of seeds now. So he should come over here, hopefully. Get War Games to start building his still and then cranking up booze. So he'll get more seeds by turning the raw materials into alcohol and getting the seeds from it. Hopefully. Yeah, it's nice now. So we have like a little dormitory, and then we've got actual proper housing for some of our dwarves. Everybody should be doing something. Yep, excellent. This is probably the hardest part of Dwarf Fortress, is just like the waiting when you have no dwarves to do anything. Nothing I can really do about that right now, sadly. Alright, let's go ahead and just kill this whole stockpile, actually. Slowly building it. Alright, actually, this would build a lot faster if we went to our woodcutter. Origami, please. You're no longer allowed to build walls or floors. Cancel that. Just, if you chop down the trees right beside it, then everybody can just, like, build really quickly from right here. I tried making an oboe. There's no wind instruments we can produce yet. It's crazy how much longer it takes to build rooms than it does to, like, mine them out. You know what I mean? Also takes a lot longer to queue up the commands for it. Here we go, though. Get some wood right here. Perfect. Okay. It's interesting, the tree fell over the roof. And inside. It's perfectly fine, to be honest. So, CW. Apparently we forgot a wall there. And then we could go ahead mine this, actually. That's true, yeah. They're better at mining than building wood houses. Yeah, that is a very dwarf thing. I've got so much wood, actually. Alright, craft dwarf. Wood crafts. Yeah, we can make hives out of that, really. Nest boxes! Ooh. Yeah, that'd be good. If you can make me a ton of nest boxes, we can get our geese set up, actually, Herpy. That'd be excellent. I really like the jungle and bark, so they look nice. And, I mean, having wood everywhere is just amazing. But, you know. Alrighty. Get this done. We just really need to chop that tree down. If you could just get on that, Mr. Origami. You're chopping some tree down. I'm not sure which one. Well, these ones here. You don't have to cut this one down, actually. That's okay. There you are. I just need to chop this guy right here. Just this one right here would be awesome. There you go. I wonder if you can actually, like, chop a tree and have it fall on people and hurt them. Like, I have no idea. So far he hasn't taken any damage from it, so presumably not, but anyway. Go ahead and yeah, we can't get on the roof. Okay. Just build a nice little bridge here. Actually, yeah, that would make sense to do a bridge instead. I like that. I like that a lot. Actually, I forget which way we set that to go. Did we just have it retract? That doesn't really matter, I suppose. That'd be really funny if you just started hacking the houses, yeah. So we want it to raise. That way. Perfect. So we just need Boro to get off his ass and go ahead and Construct the building. Perfect. It's happening. Okay, Origami, you're now allowed to chop or build. Build the wood stuff again. Don't you worry. You've had your privileges given back. And hopefully we build this bridge fairly quickly. We need our carpenter to do it, but he's not doing anything at the moment. Herpy's busy working on his nest boxes. 48 HWQ plus hello? What? Talking about flex point, you crazy man. How did you get here, Borrowed? What? Just, I think Borrowed's a bit of a special guy. He teleported on top of the houses, unless he... Can you run from over here? No. Yeah, you can, right? So we don't even need the bridge, do we? Apparently not. Borrowed's just like... he just walks around, everyone's like... What are you doing, you wizard? How did that happen? And he's like, why didn't you guys just, you know, walk around? Why do we need the bridge, exactly? What was that about? Fair enough, Borrowed. Fair enough. Let's use delicious coffee wood logs for our roof. That's a Borrowed thing to do, though, for sure. Use more of our coffee wood. Delicious coffee wood. It's got to be a nice color, actually. Alright, get building, boys. So I can start putting the frickin', you know, beds in there and stuff. We can actually give people proper bedrooms. Hopefully, some of this will start. Yeah, if you want the job done, the easiest way is make a lazy person do it. Yep. With the 100%. Okay, we got some nest boxes done. Let's go ahead and set them up. Oh, say over here. Hopefully, they'll start giving us eggs in a while. Imagine a house that smells like coffee all the time. Oh, that'd be nice. You know, the interesting thing about doing an outside fort is we could actually leave a single hole of light in the middle of their rooms. It would rain through it and stuff like that. But it would keep the dwarves so they're used to being outside. Otherwise what happens is your dwarves live underground for the majority of their life. When they come up and see the sunlight for the first time in a while, they start puking, which is really funny because you'll be fighting off invaders and it's like, soldiers, storm the gates, they're coming. And everyone starts running up and they get outside and they start vomiting and tripping all over their vomit and going like, oh God, why has this happened to me? But, oh well. So far, no jaguars either, which is, well, it's nice, I guess. Just chop down all these. Nah, we can leave those trees for now. Yes, Elphys would love that house, yeah. I'd not chop down that tree. Go ahead and chop that one at some point. We just need Herpy to just make all the wooden crafts. Actually, we can have him make cups. Yeah, go ahead and do that. Unless, can we make mugs here? Wooden mug? No, I don't see it. So yeah, if we make cups, the Borrowed was complaining that he didn't drink out of a cup. I guess he just uses hands to take the beer out of the keg. So, you know, might be a good idea. So funny watching dwarves build. They work in such mysterious ways. Music's kind of like Donkey Kong or something. So we're gonna set up a bridge for our like main gate. And we're gonna keep it open, but we can close it if we needed to. Fortunately, you need a mechanic and mechanisms. And mechanisms only come from rock. It's underground, we can't do anything about that until winter. Winter, we're just gonna have to dig down real fast, mine everything, get it out. Yeah. Ah, a keg. What's this? No cups? Well, guess I'll improvise. Jumps into the keg. Oh, I thought you were gonna be like, what plebeians drinking with their hands? We got Herpy over there, just like trying to use his feet to pick up the alcohol. It's not working, guys. No Herpy. So we can start building our first bed now. Beautiful. Oh man, coffee wood beds. Okay, these aren't inside yet. It's gotta be nice. Just the whole place just smelling of that delicious coffee. Still counts. That's right, Bard. Yeah. Man, I was really hoping we could find like some stone. But that's all right. It's a little bit of a challenge run. Wasn't intentional, but it is now. What if I, you know what? What if I just try digging into random other places? Like, if we dig over here. Wonder if we can find any that way. This has got to increase our value a little bit. I know dwarves don't go, oh, wood. But I mean, like, come on. Just need some migrants. Nice. Well, speaking of, okay, so to make a. Well, hang on. I suppose we can build our nest boxes before I forget. There we go. Okay, so to build a pump, because that's what we'll need. It will be a. Is that under traps and levers? No, I know it's under something weird though, right? Machine components. Screw pump. To build a screw pump, we need a block, a screw trap component, and a pipe section. All right, I know we can make. Pipe section, yes. Block, I know I can make one of those here, yes. Screw trap. See, I don't see that here. That might be under the craft. I'll make instrument. Street, a wooden horn. Yeah, there we go. An Isar. Oh yeah, let's make one of those for Herpy. Now that I think of it, only used wood, building above ground, weird houses out of wood, no digging. Vote of no confidence. Expedition leader has gone insane. Yeah, you'll all be thanking me later. Maybe. Maybe not. You'll all thank me when the goblins come. They just bring a lighter. It's like, well, you know, you can't win them all. I'd like to, but you can't, so. Either way, guys, I think this is where we call it for the night. We started doing stuff. We haven't really got too far, and again, the aquifer thing is a bit of a nuisance. Let's admit it. I might tomorrow, before work, if I get time, just generate a couple worlds and see if I can find an interesting embark. Is that something I can sort of just like start searching for something, you know, go do some stuff and then come back. And we might find a better embark and I might give it a go then. Because it doesn't feel right. You guys, you know, that's the problem. It doesn't feel right building everything out of wood. It doesn't feel right being above the ground. And I hate dealing with aquifers. Like, to even solve an aquifer is a problem and a half. But, you know, things happen. So, anyway, I am... which one? Doesn't say save and quit anymore. Retire the fortress for the time being sounds about right. Really quit all action. All active saves will be deleted. Yes. Okay. Anyway, take it easy, guys. You all have a nice night, and I'll see you tomorrow, as always.